All right, peace and blessings, and welcome to another author spotlight here in Self-Publishing 30 Days. My name is Rob YB Youngblood, president of sales for Self-Publishing 30 Days, and I'm here with Verna Mayers Falkunle.
You got it.
Come on, let's go. See, we were talking about saying her last name. She's going to tell you where that name originated from in a moment, but I'm so happy to have Verna here on the author spotlight because Verna is a true supporter of the things that we're doing. And I'm sure she'll talk about that momentarily, but Verna's an author. She's a higher education administrator. She's done some tremendous things in her career. And so Verna, welcome to the author spotlight. How are you doing today?
I'm great. Thank you so much for having me, Rob. I appreciate it.
Thank you for your encouragement. Now let's start there, right? So Falkunle.
Falkunle is Nigerian.
Nigerian.
My husband is actually Nigerian. And so that's the generation. That's where the name originates from.
I love it.
And it's just like it sounds. If you saw how it was spelled, if your viewers could see how it was spelled, it's not that difficult. I think it's intimidating.
Yeah, for me, I want to make sure I'm perfect. But, you know, oftentimes perfection leads to other things. And so the fact that you coached me through that process is great because nobody wants to mess up anybody's name. And
right.
So your name is your name. And so definitely.
Right. And, you know, that's like a proud name,
No doubt.
So their name is, you know, it's definitely proud for them. So,
it took
me a minute to get it. And I'm married.
I bet.
So give yourself some grace.
I'm putting a pat on my back for those of you. Listening, I'm putting a pat on my back.
That's right. Give yourself some grace.
So, Verna, please tell us a little bit about yourself.
So, of course, Rob already mentioned that I've spent a lot of time in higher education. I am going to talk about that in a minute, but just my own origins. I am a true Southern Belle, born and raised in the South. I've spent the majority of my time living in the South. I am actually just kind of happenstance, just started working in higher education. I actually went to a college for a temp assignment that was for 2 days, and I ended up staying for 16 years. Mm-hmm. So, but it has always been just the favor of God on my life. You know, he turned that 2 day assignment into a 23 year career. Mm-hmm. And I've done pretty much everything which in the gamut of higher education. I've been an administrative assistant. I've been, you know, a faculty member. I've been an administrator. God has just really blessed me to be able to move and advance in that industry. I even spent time, Rob, as an assistant athletic director for like 3 or 4 years.
Okay.
Yeah. So when I say I've done it all, I've really pretty much done it all. And I loved my time in higher education. I love working with students. I love impacting their lives. You know, it's just a family oriented environment. I've spent most of my time, actually all of my time at HBCU. So you already know that's just like a family environment. So, so I loved my time in higher education, but even still, I felt led to do the things that I knew God was calling me to do outside of my professional experience.
Right.
You know, so it's wonderful to live your purpose in professionalism. And I think for those 23 years, that's what my purpose was.
Mm-hmm.
But I also realized that there were some things that God was calling me to do outside of that arena. And I was too afraid to do it. I was just, you know, too afraid to step out on faith and, you know, do the things that he was calling me to do. And writing a book was one of them. You know, it was the fearful thing for me. So, you know, being in higher education, teaching and interacting with students, that came natural.
Right.
Putting yourself out there for the world to like judge you and hear your story and read about your mess, like that's hard.
Yeah.
So it took me a long time to get the boldness and the courage to just say, you know what, I'm just going to do this scared. I'm going to do it afraid. You know, but I felt like if I didn't do it, the repercussions and consequences of not doing what God was calling me to do was going to be greater than living with that fear. And I didn't want that. I want to leave this earth knowing that I gave God every bit back of what he instilled in me, you know, when he created me. So, so I'm, of course, a wife. You already know that. Don't have any natural children. I raised my niece and my nephew. So I am the bonus mom to a 28-year-old and a 24-year-old. My niece, she's doing her thing in the business industry. My nephew is in the military, married with two little babies.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm a bonus grandmom. You know, So I'm excited just about all God has for me, you know, in the future. So that's me in a nutshell, Rob.
Yeah, I love it. I appreciate you sharing that, Verna. So tell us about your book. Tell us, give us the name of it and tell us what prompted you to write your book.
Okay, so the name of my book is Living Big, Bold, Inspired, and Gifted, Shattering the Looking Glass to Release the Greatness Within. And I wrote it just really going back to what I was just saying. I wanted to help people who, like me, were afraid to live in the boldness of who God had created them to be. You know, I've spent my life as an overweight everything, overweight kid, overweight teen, overweight adult. And for a long time, I allowed, you know, people's opinions and thoughts of me to hinder me. You know, I was afraid to be vulnerable because most of the time, vulnerability came with pain. You know, so when you put yourself out there as an overweight person, you just don't know what you're going to get back. You know, people are judgmental, people are cruel, people are mean, you know, and so I learned how to close myself off, to protect myself from being hurt. I didn't want to do that.
Right.
And then not only what other people were saying, Rob, but then also what I allowed myself to start thinking about myself. Mm-hmm. And so all of those things hindered me from living life in a big, bold way. And I wanted to use the acronym BIG because I wanted to give myself power over what it meant, over what that word meant. So for most of my life, being big meant something negative. And I wanted to shift that into something positive. Mm-hmm. And so for me, big means bold. It means inspired. It means gifted. Mm-hmm. It means finally being able to stand up authentically 100% in who I am, whether I'm 100 pounds, 400 pounds, 600 pounds, whatever.
Right.
I'm going to be bold enough to stand in my authentic truth and share everything that God has instilled in me with the world. And that's what my book is about. I want to encourage people who are struggling with their own fears, with their own challenges, you know, who are stuck, you know, to help them get unstuck and help them to understand that, now, number one, you can't do it in your own power. So for me, that journey started with realizing that everything that I needed had already been instilled in me from the time that God, you know, he formed me.
Yeah.
So it wasn't even when he was born. It's already been put inside you when God formed you. So, you know, he's given you what you need. And if he's called you to it, he'll see you through it.
Yeah.
So I wanted to share that story with the world. I want to inspire people to be their best self, to live their best lives, you know, and to get over, you know, their own negative images and negative stereotypes of themselves.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's pretty much it in a nutshell.
That's such a phenomenal desire to write that type of book, because you see so many people that do struggle in different aspects of their lives, and they may often think that they're the only one. And so when they can see someone else that, you know, that they can relate to, it definitely opens them up and encourages them to take the necessary steps to live big, as you mentioned. Right. I love the acronym, by the way. So what would you say was the biggest challenge that you had to overcome in writing your book?
I would say vulnerability.
Okay.
So you can't help, you know, people if you're not willing to share your own story.
Right.
And so for me, it meant really owning, like, your own mess. I think I said that earlier, but this book really challenged me to own my own mess. Like, I think it's so easy sometimes, especially when we deal with like self-doubt and, you know, fear, and it's so easy to blame other people.
Right.
And so, and I'm not saying that, you know, other people may not have hurt you or hurt, you know, I'm not saying other people didn't hurt me,
right,
but what I'm
right.
saying is, until I was able to own my own contribution to where I was, then I wasn't able to heal.
Yeah.
And so the healing process was probably the hardest thing. So I tell everybody, like, I know people say you should be able to write a book in, you know, 3 months or 6 months or a year. That was not, that didn't work. That didn't happen for me, because my book grew with me. It grew through things with me. So, you know, it took me a while, because this is a process. And that's one of the things that I talk about in my book, like, allow yourself to go through the process to get to your healing.
Yeah.
You know, and so for me, the hardest thing was living through that pain, dealing with all of that, you know, all that mess that I had hidden down in my heart. When I say I had a shell, a wall broken up, I had a wall built up to protect myself. And so, you know, allowing God to kind of chip through at that wall and say, okay, today we're going to deal with, you know, how you feel about your looks. you know, and, you know, going in the mirror and being like, yeah, okay, so I don't see anything positive. You know, those things that work, Rob, it was so hard.
Yeah.
It was so hard. But, and so it took me a minute. You know, there were days when I had to say, yeah, I'm just not feeling that today.
Right.
So I'm going to just give myself a little break, you know, but it took the process. Took a long time. So I think that was the hardest thing for me is just following through with the process of healing and being vulnerable and being open to the world. Because you don't know how people are going to receive that.
Right.
And not only that, but people that know you, like a lot of them don't know the stuff that, you know, I put in this book. So they're going to be like, well, who was she? You know, who, you know, all this time we thought we knew who she was, but we didn't really know. And the sad thing is because all this time, all my life, I thought I knew who I was.
Right.
You know? But this book challenged me to really figure out who I was and who God made me to be.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. So talk a little bit about the win. So your book, you finished your book, you published your book. What has been some of the wins that you've achieved after putting your book out there? Like, you know, did you get the type of response that you expected? Was it, you know, did you start having people respond and saying, thank you for writing this book? Give me some wins that you achieved as a result of putting your book together.
Yeah, definitely. I think I've been really encouraged by the feedback and the number of people that just say, you know, my thing is not your thing. Like, I don't deal with weight, but here's my thing.
Right.
So, you know, and that's what I wanted. I wanted my book to help people regardless of what their challenge was.
Yeah.
And so getting the validation from people who may not necessarily be going through what I'm going through, but they're going through their thing and hearing them say, your book helped me get through my thing. That's been like the greatest, you know, reward for me.
Yeah.
You know, I am actually pre-selling my book, you know, and that kind of thing. And so even having like beta readers and just through the whole process, the feedback has been just really positive and really great. And I'm so, it confirms for me that, you know, there's purpose in this work and there's purpose in this book. And that's all I really care about. Like, I know there are authors that write and they're like, I want to, you know, make a lot of money and I want to launch a business. And I'm not saying I don't want to do those things, but for me, the greatest thing is I want to help people.
Yeah.
You know, I want my story to impact somebody's life in such a way that they just like, you know, they walk into their destiny in a way that they never thought they could.
Yeah.
And so I think that's the greatest win for me is just knowing that, you know what, I'm helping somebody. Mm-hmm. You know, my story, you know, my boldness, you know, giving in to doing it afraid, all of that is worth it if I help just one person.
Yeah, I love it.
So that's been the greatest win for me.
I love it. And you know, the most important thing is to be your best advocate and be able to promote it in such a way that people understand that number one, it exists, but number two, who is it for? So when you think about who this book is for, like I know you were general when you mentioned, you know, why you wrote the book, but if you had to just be specific about the type of people who would benefit from this book, who would be those type of people? Like, you know, now obviously we know people dealing with challenges or whatever, but if you had to identify 2 to 3 types of people that would definitely benefit from reading your book, who would those people be?
So I would say, and I'll try to be specific. I talk in generic because it's just so, I think the area just encompasses so many people and everybody's story is different. But I would say if you have low self-esteem and that low self-esteem has kept you stuck, meaning you're afraid to confront, you know, your past even, or you've been hurt in your past or you're being hurt now. You know that there's purpose in you. You know that you have destiny, but you're too afraid to heal. Because here's the thing, Rob, dealing with pain is painful.
Yeah.
You know, when you have to confront your pain and heal from your pain, that process is painful. Mm-hmm. Sometimes even more painful than the original hurt. Mm-hmm. So I would say anyone out there who is stuck, like, I know I'm not supposed to be here. I know I'm supposed to be somewhere other than where I am, but I don't know how to get there. I don't know what to do to get past, you know, my past. That's the person that I'm writing for.
Okay.
You know, anybody who, you know, I see my destiny, I see my future, but I have no clue how to heal past, you know, the trauma, you know, or even people who, you know, they have their own negative opinions of themselves. Like for me, for a long time, I didn't write or I didn't speak or I didn't do anything because I felt like, who wants to hear from you?
Right.
You know, and if you're afraid that there's no one out there who's going to listen to you, who wants to hear from you, then this book is for you.
Okay.
You know, so I think that in a nutshell, I think that is the people that I want to talk to the most. People who are too afraid to move, people who are too hurt to shift, you know, those are the people that I want to help.
That's good. I appreciate you being transparent on that. And so as we begin to land the plane, Verna, tell us, if you had one location in the world, say, for example, when you, obviously you've gotten your book out the way, it's about to come out, you're doing pre-orders, everything like that. Say you're ready to write your next book. You had any place in the world to go to write this book, right? So that you get inspiration or just clarity. And I was paying for it. Like I was cutting a check. Where would you go? Where would you travel to write your next book?
I can think of a few places, but I am a beach person. Mm-hmm. I love tropical. Probably one of my favorite places in the world is Hawaii.
Okay.
So probably like on a beach surrounded by just lush tropical mm-hmm. trees, relaxation, the water, the ocean.
Yeah.
That's probably where I would go. Anything ocean, anything water, like that's my jam.
Yeah.
So I'm thinking Hawaii would probably be a really good place for me. And also because it's not so overly saturated, you know, with people all the time.
Yeah, there are places
that you can go in Hawaii where you can really have just that quiet, serene experience. Even though it's a touristy place, you can still find those places, those nooks where you can kind of be, you know, I'm a tourist, but I'm not a tourist.
Right.
So I think Hawaii would be the place where I would go.
I love it. I love it. So let's tell everybody, how can they contact you? How can they get access to your book? How can they support your movement?
So the book can be purchased on my website, and my website is Verna Mayers Bakule at .com. Also, I am on LinkedIn as Verna Mayers Bakule. I am on Instagram and Twitter as Verna Inspires. And there's a link to my book at both places on Instagram and Twitter. Facebook, also Verna Mayers Bakule. So I'm easy to find. Probably the best way is Instagram at Verna Inspires, just because I don't want y'all to have to figure out how to spell my last name. So Verna Inspires on Instagram will connect you to all of my other ways to connect me, my website, LinkedIn, all of the above.
Well, Verna, it's definitely been a pleasure having you on the Author Spotlight. Is there any last words or last thoughts from your heart that you want to share with the listeners and those who may be watching?
Yeah, I just, you know, first of all, again, I want to thank you, Rob, for inviting me to the platform and allowing me to share. I just want to say that this book comes from my heart. You know, I really, really want to help people get beyond where they are and, you know, be the best at whatever it is that God has called them to be. And so I really want to speak to the people out there who think they can't. And I just want to tell them that you can, you know, no matter what your hangup is, no matter what your past was like, no matter what you even see in your future, do it scared, do it afraid, just step out, take the leap. Because here's the thing, once you take the leap, the stairs will appear. But if you never leap, you'll never know, you know, what could have been. And I was so afraid. I did not want to wake up one day and say, I wish I could have, I wish I would have, I wish I did. So don't be those, you know, don't be that person. This book is written so people will know you can. You absolutely can do whatever that big thing is that you dream about. You can do it. So, you know, that's what I want to leave the audience with. Just know that you can. Even if you never buy my book, just hear me say to you today that you can. And go out there and try. And you will be surprised at how great your results will be.
I love it, Verna. Thank you so much for gracing us with your presence. And for those of you who are watching, make sure and listening, make sure to go out and support Verna. You can catch her information. You'll see it in the show notes. You'll be able to just, you know, connect with her on LinkedIn. That's she and I rock on LinkedIn heavy. As a matter of fact, she's a super supporter on Clubhouse. And we really appreciate her for her support, not only of me, but of Self-Publishing 30 Days. And so as we wrap up this conversation with a phenomenal author, I want you to be encouraged, be blessed, but also remember to share your faith and do like Verna's doing and live big, right? Live big and understand that your best is yet to come as you operate in your gift, because your gift will make room for you. We'll see you on the next episode. Peace.
Thank you, Rob. Thank you so much.
All right, peace.